What if I told you there's a globally recognized framework that helps organizations design, plan, implement, and manage their enterprise architecture efficiently? A framework that's been adopted by some of the world's biggest tech players, from banks to software giants, to bring clarity and consistency to their transformation journeys. That framework is TOGAF. And today, we're diving deep into what it is and why it's a game changer for enterprise architects. Hi everyone, welcome back to Topictrick. In this video, we're continuing our journey into the world of enterprise architecture with Lecture 2, an overview of the TOGAF standard. Whether you're just starting out as an architect or you've been building systems for years, understanding TOGAF can give you a powerful lens to structure and scale architecture work more effectively. So, what are we covering today? First, we'll briefly explore what TOGAF is and why it was created. Then, we'll break down its key components in plain terms, like the ADM cycle, content framework, and enterprise continuum. We'll also look at how software organizations use TOGAF in real-world scenarios. Finally, we'll wrap up with the essential takeaways you should walk away with. Let's start with the basics. TOGAF stands for the Open Group Architecture Framework. It's a comprehensive framework for developing enterprise architecture that was first introduced in the mid-90s and has evolved significantly since then. The current version, TOGAF Standard, 10th edition, is modular, more flexible, and better aligned with modern digital transformation challenges. At its core, TOGAF provides a methodology to help organizations build and maintain their architectures. It's vendor neutral, which means you can apply it whether you're working with Microsoft Azure, AWS, Salesforce, or any other stack. One of the central parts of TOGAF is the ADM, the Architecture Development Method. This is a step-by-step cycle that guides architects through understanding the business, designing the architecture, transitioning into implementation, and managing change. The ADM includes phases like preliminary, architecture vision, business architecture, information systems architecture, technology architecture, and so on. It's like a map that ensures you don't jump from idea to execution without understanding the terrain. Let's connect this to the software industry. Imagine you're part of a SaaS company that's scaling quickly. Let's say it's a project management platform like Monday.com or Asana. The business wants to expand into new markets, integrate with more third-party tools, and move parts of the system to the cloud. You can't just start coding features or migrating servers. You need to first understand the business goals, assess existing systems, identify gaps, and plan a path forward. That's where the ADM provides structured guidance. It ensures the architecture you build isn't just technically sound, but strategically aligned. Another key component of TOGAF is the content framework. This defines the types of deliverables, artifacts, and building blocks that should be created during an architecture project. For example, you might produce a business capability map, data flow diagrams, or a technology roadmap. TOGAF doesn't force you to follow one format. It gives you a toolkit that you can tailor to your organization's needs. The enterprise continuum is another powerful concept. It helps you manage architecture at different levels, from generic solutions that apply across industries to specific architectures tailored for your business. Think of it like a library of architectural patterns you can reuse. For software companies, this means you're not reinventing the wheel every time. If you're designing a secure login system, you can leverage patterns and best practices instead of starting from scratch. And let's not forget governance. TOGAF emphasizes the importance of having strong architectural governance, meaning you're not just designing architecture in isolation, but also making sure it's followed, monitored, and improved over time. This is particularly important in software environments where change happens fast. And without governance, things can spiral into technical debt very quickly. Now let's take a real-world example. Consider a global software provider like SAP. When SAP undertakes a large-scale platform redesign or integrates a new acquisition, they need consistency across business units, clear visibility into systems, and a shared vocabulary for architecture. Frameworks like TOGAF help guide these transformations at scale, ensuring that different teams aren't pulling in different directions. So, to sum up today's lecture, TOGAF is a comprehensive framework used globally to guide enterprise architecture development. it provides a structured approach through its ADM cycle, which covers everything from vision to implementation. Its modular tools like the Content Framework and Enterprise Continuum help tailor the architecture process to your organization. Software companies use TOGAF to manage complexity, maintain alignment with business goals, and drive scalable transformations. Thanks for watching today's lecture. If you learned something new, make sure to like this video, subscribe to the Topictrick YouTube channel, and share it with other architects or tech professionals who could benefit from this.